everybody who served us this morning. We've got our tithes and our offering first of all. We're going to ask Brother Tony. Brother Matthews, would you come and help us take up the offering? Lord loves a cheerful giver. Amen.
Amen.
So we ask you to give this morning as given unto the Lord. Brother Matthews, ask God's blessing.
Father, I pray that you bless this offering to its intended use. In the name of Jesus Christ, we ask. Amen.
Amen.
Ask you to stand this morning. We're going to sing. Come, Holy Spirit. We need you this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. We're going to take the news to the Lord in prayer this time. We have a special spoken request, anyone? Anyone else?
Our cousin Tanya, her husband's uncle Alonzo Mitchell, he is going to be having a kidney transplant today in Tennessee. So if you could just remember him in prayer, and they should be heading out, so just remember them as they travel to Tennessee as well.
Any other prayer requests? Let's all stand this morning.
Don't forget West Texas, the media and everybody's kind of forgot about them, the ELS, the police, firefighters,
yes.
Just basically evaporating that energy.
Yes.
We have much to pray about this morning. Let's pray for one another and pray for the lost.
Yes.
Each one praying in their own way.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, we come to you once again.
We come to you right now, Lord. Putting our burdens right on you, Lord God Jesus. For you know that you're the bearer of our burdens. We know that you're able to answer all these prayers to Lord God Jesus. And pray to Todd's uncle, Alonzo Mitchell, in prayer to Lord God Jesus, as he's having a kidney transplant today, Lord. Please keep your angels around them as they travel to Tennessee. Please remember the people of West Texas, dear Lord God Jesus, who have lost their lives, their family, their friends, and their loved ones. There's fathers, sons, brothers, everybody, dear Lord God Jesus. And remember the lost, dear Lord God Jesus, as you can put the ease in their heart, Lord, to know that they can come to you anytime, and you'll be their Savior, dear Lord God Jesus. And I ask it in your name right now. Amen.
Thank you. story, the songs he's been talking about Calvary. This song, it says, a crown of thorns. He went to the cross of Calvary for us and gave his life that he might come in. It's been a while, so I have to decide what to give, but the same thing.
Young man, if you would help an old preacher. not built for an old man 80 years old. You would have seen it. And you're a cousin, aren't you? You're helping a kinfolk. Thank you. Yeah, stay right there. So good to have the invitation, and we've known Brother and Sister Singleton for a long time, and Trevor, she's alive with the party. Oh, I really enjoy her. She'd liven up any church, and you're really blessed to have them as pastors. What good people. If they'd furnish me a shuttle bus, I might come over from Granite City. And Florine, my. The years and years, Florine. Happy Holland, Charlie Mayberry, and the church way down in the holler. And Eldon, my friend Eldon Anderson. These years have come and gone. I guess that's all your kin folks are, aren't they? Isn't that beautiful? So nice. Hello, cousins. And I just finished 60 years of preaching. I had my first church when I was 18. And I'm like Moses, I just hate to give it up. God had to drag him up the hill and kill him because he wanted to keep pastoring. And I met Brother and Sister Matthews and Brother Strange and my kid folks. And Walter, I forget where he's at. And I want to thank you for having us. And so I've been way down in Kentucky, Pastor. And we left the church with a good congregation, $120,000 in the bank. I didn't run over no piano player. And we turned it over to a young man, and my daughter, Ruth Brim, she's pastoring the church at Granite City that I had 40 years ago. And my girl and her husband has got the church, Sunset Hill, and all of it. And this sweet girl I found in the holler, and this is our anniversary, 54 years. And they all thought she married wrong, but she didn't. I ran off with the piano player, and her father never did come to get her. I've raised her since mighty near 17 she was. I won't tell you the age now since I said 54. Years. So we're glad to be here. And God bless Brother Sister Singleton. Sorry about his wonderful mother. And I want to do good because I want to come back. And so we live over down in Granite City. And I go to the old church that I used to pastor. And this is my sweetheart. And my closest friend that I've had all my life. Bessie can play anything. She can. And even whistle.
You're saying where he says anything else. I appreciate the Lord this morning. I'm thankful for the privilege to serve him. And I enjoyed our Sunday school class today. Sometimes we forget how wonderful Jesus really is and the great price he paid for us. But the fact that he went to Calvary when he didn't even have to, but because he loved us, isn't that something? And I'm glad that the Lord saved me when I was just a child, and I haven't regretted 1 mile that I've traveled for the Lord. He's been so faithful to me. Doesn't make any difference what your need is. Jesus is the answer. Praise God.
A woman
who had strong faith. And it's found in the 27th verse. That's a good PA man there. Appreciate that. When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. The Bible said that God has given a measure of faith to all men. Jesus said to the woman in the Bible, I have not found such great faith in all Israel. Great faith. He told the disciples when they had a terrible circumstance, he said, oh, ye have little faith. Here's a woman that had strong faith in God. She wouldn't take no for an answer. Most women don't. It's best just to go ahead and agree with them. And so, here is a woman that had an issue of blood for 12 years. She was excommunicated from the church of the Old Testament because they weren't allowed in the sanctuary with the flowing of blood. So she didn't get to go to church. And she tried everything she could to be healed. I think the most of us, we want to live. I think it's a great honor to God to be alive, to preach the gospel, give out tracts, win souls. The most of us, we're not ready for the mortuary yet. I have a friend that's a mortician, and he shakes my hand, and he checks my blood pressure in my wrist. And he said, nope, you're not ready yet. I'll be 79, and so no matter what the doctor said, she'd go to one, and they said, you're hopeless. But here's a woman that had such strong faith in God that not even a doctor could make her become discouraged. And she'd try another one. Another doctor, same answer, you're going to die and not live. And she tried many physicians until all of her money was spent. I think probably what she was waiting on was a second opinion. And I think it'd do us all good. God don't look at blood pressure. And he doesn't look at cancer. And he doesn't go by x-rays. No, faith is a substance of things hoped for. And the evidence of things not seen. God's children look at the unseen. We look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are unseen. The things that are seen are temporal, but the things that are not seen are eternal. God's children lives above sea level. Hello. Amen. It was what the spies saw that discouraged them. That's true. And we don't look at the things which are seen. These are discouraging days. But we look at the unseen. And that's what this woman did. God holds our life. He promised us 70 and by reason of strength 80. And then the Bible said, we shall come to our grave like an old shuck of corn. And if you're a farmer, you know what that means. That means you're not going to leave here to God once you've gone. Doctors don't hold our life. No. Our life is held in the hands of God.
Amen.
It is appointed unto men once to die. But after this, the judgment, God holds our appointed time. And here was a woman who would not accept death. Everybody told her she's going to die. All the doctors said she was a hopeless case. But that's what God deals in. When your back is to the wall, that's when God steps in. Hallelujah. Yeah, I was once young. Now I'm old, and never have I saw the righteous forsaken.
Amen.
Thank you, brother. Nor his seed begging bread.
Amen.
Oh, I'm with you always, even unto the end of the world.
Amen.
He that endureth unto the end shall be saved. Don't be a quitter.
Yeah.
And don't give up too soon. God has something for you. You're not an accident. God puts you on this earth for a purpose. Seek His will. God will guide you and your family all the days of your life, and you will be blessed.
Amen.
You know what God said about Christian people? He said, I have made you the head and not the tail.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're not a bunch of dry, washed wood going down the stream of a river. We are a peculiar people.
Yes.
A chosen generation. Yes. A peculiar people. That don't mean odd. That means special.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
God don't have stepchildren. We're all sons.
Yes.
And we're all daughters.
Lord.
I feel the Holy Ghost. We call Him Abba Father. And we step into His presence.
Thank you, Jesus.
And whatsoever we ask in His name, He will do it.
Amen. That's what He said.
Ask! And you shall receive.
Amen.
Seek. You'll find. Knock. And it shall be opened.
Amen.
Those words mean
yeah.
Keep knocking.
Amen.
That man that needed bread at midnight, and he went to his neighbor's house and knocked on the door, and the man said, get away. I've got all my children in bed. Please quit knocking on the door and making noise. anybody that's ever put any children to bed, we had to rock seats out of our rockers to get children to go to sleep. Maybe you didn't have to do that. My Indian mother, I had an Indian mother, and she fed us onion tea and made us eat lettuce. And we went to sleep easy. Chloroform. Maybe you know what I'm talking about. So, he said, I'm not leaving. I come for bread. I've got company. I have nothing in my house. I'm going to stay here and knock until I get what I come for. And let me tell you, church, that's exactly what God wants you to do.
Amen. Yeah.
In a hopeless situation, keep knocking.
Yeah.
I'm sorry if I raised my voice. I'm just from the old school. I could preach on the street corner without any microphones. Keep knocking. His ears are open unto your cry. And his arms are not short that he cannot save.
Amen.
And that man knew that outside his door was a man that was desperate. And he got up and gave him as many a loaf of bread that he wants. If you're going to get anything from God, the violent taketh it before. And you're going to have to be desperate. She said, I won't accept it. And somebody told her about Jesus. Maybe they went to the Friendship Church of Assembly. I don't know who it was. Somebody witnessed to her and said, you know about Jesus? He's passing by and he can heal you of your disease. And she tried a second opinion.
Yeah.
I'm talking to somebody here in the building today that you ought to try Jesus. You ought to try a second opinion. Jesus Christ has come to seek and to save that which was lost. He's looking for you today. And she said, I'm going to try Jesus. And I'm going to try a second opinion. It's a shame that nobody went with her. Sometimes you got to go when your husband don't go. Sometimes you got to go when your companion and your children won't go. Her husband didn't go with her. When she went to find Jesus, then you've got to make up your mind to go yourself.
Amen.
Hello.
Yeah.
Her children knew she was going to die, and she was a hopeless case because all the doctors said so. But she went without him. Not even the pastor. No preacher. If the preacher don't go, remember that song? It won't hinder me. I'm going to go to Jesus whatever the cost. I'm desperate. I need help. I've tried everything else. And they tell me that Jesus can absolutely change this circumstance.
Amen.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I'm looking for a clock. Harley, please, get me a clock. Hezekiah, when Isaiah walked in to the king of Hezekiah, not many of us get our obituary read before we're dead. But Isaiah read Hezekiah's obituary in his presence and said, "You're going to die and not live." Told him. He read his obituary, and the preacher turned his back, and before he could get to the lobby, Hezekiah said, "I don't receive that. I won't accept it." He put his face to the wall.
Yeah.
And he cried.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
Oh God.
Yeah.
In my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and pray. He's a God that answers prayer.
Amen.
He put his face to the wall and prayed. And God met Isaiah before he got to the lobby. And he said, "Isaiah, turn around. Turn around and go back to Hezekiah and tell him that he's not going to die." Folks, I want to tell you, there's a God that loves you.
Yes. Yeah.
And there's a God that cares for you. And there's a God that wants to help your family, your setbacks in finance, your jobs, your life, your health. All you got to do is call on him. We have not because we ask not. And God said, "Go tell Hezekiah he's going to live 15 more years."
Yeah.
Let's give the Lord a hand over. To these young people down here, 15 years, what's that? Nothing. But it means a whole lot to somebody that's 80.
Yes.
You're going to live. And you're not going to die. And King Hezekiah was a father of a brand new baby in that length of time. You don't know the surprise that God has for you in the future.
Amen. Yeah.
He's got a surprise for you. He had one for Hezekiah. And no matter how it comes, whether it's UPS, when God sends it, I don't care about the wrapping. And I don't care what ribbon it's in, chlorine. If God sends it, it'll be exactly what I need. God has something for you. Don't give up. Don't quit. Don't turn around. She said, "If I can touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole." She didn't care who prayed for her. Never even asked for Peter. Peter raised the dead. Never asked for James, the pastor of the church. Never asked for St. John, who wrote the book of Revelation. She pressed her way through the press. And if you get anything through God today, you're going to have to get through the things that bothers you.
Amen. Yeah.
Did you know that a frog eats the things that bothers him? Ain't that good deep preaching right here at dinner time? You have to learn how to make lemonade out of all the lemons that you come in contact with. Hello.
Amen.
She went through the press. She never looked for anyone to lay hands on her. Oh, what strong faith. What strong faith that this woman had. And even in Mother's Day, it really takes a lot of strong faith to raise a family in this age now. My dad was one of 22. My grandpa I had two grandmas. My first one died. She had 11. And my next one had 11 more. I've got Gallaghers all over the United States that I ain't never met. Anyway, she pressed through the crowd and she fell at the feet of Jesus, reached out and touched the hem of his garment. Notice what the Bible says. She felt. She was healed in her body. And the blood stopped. There's a lot of people that says, you can't go by feelings. If you have enough faith, you'll have feelings.
Yes. Oh, yes.
And she touched, the flow of blood stopped, and she was healed. I wonder what that pastor thought when he wouldn't go with her to get healed of Jesus. I wonder when she walked past the ushers and sat down on the front seat and he looked down there and he saw a brand new woman healed by the power of God.
Yeah. Amen.
Let's give the Lord a praise. Sister Gallagher, please come. Sister Matthew, you can play that organ. You're welcome. You're welcome. Mama, she played organ, accordion, bass guitar, play a radio. She's really telling it. Today, just remain seated with your head bowed. Are you here this morning? I really felt, I got this sermon early this morning. I was up at 2:30. Are you in this building this morning? And you could say, Brother Gallagher, I've had so many setbacks. I've had setbacks financially. My marriage is on the rocks. I've got a lot of family trouble in among my children. I've got a horrible, awful disease that the doctors can't cure. And I just keep going back. To the doctor's office. I need help. While I'm speaking, would you like to call on God this morning, whatever your situation is? If you're a sinner, if you're a backslider, If you're a Christian that needs help, the Bible says, oh, when my heart is overwhelmed within me, lead me to that rock that's higher than I. I'm stretching out my hand to you, and I want to lead you to the rock this morning. I'd like for all the Christians to get up. I'd like for the sinners, the backsliders, everyone that needs healing for your body, let's all come and let's pray around the altar this morning. Everybody come. A woman who had strong faith, and she would not take no for an answer. Thank you for coming. Get up. Everyone just pray. You can pray sitting in a pew behind. You can pray sitting in a pew. Let's all bow our heads.
And your life will never be the same. There is only one way to touch Him. You must be.
Lord back. Brother Gallagher will be preaching for us again. Enjoyed it this morning. It was good.
My wife has got so many relatives here, they have never heard her preach. And she's got way over 50 years of preaching. I'm going to let her do the preaching.
But she'll be singing and preaching.
Way over 50 years. I might have to do the piano playing and singing.
It's going to be good either way.